breaking news in the Mueller investigation. A source tells CNN that Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein plans to leave the Justice Department once William Barr, the president's nominee for Attorney General, is confirmed. That will likely happen sometime in February. Barr's confirmation hearing begins next Tuesday, and I have to say the stakes just went up in a big way. We should note our sources say Rosenstein is not being forced out. He has overseen the special counsel's Russia investigation for more than a year, and with him gone, it means that oversight of the probe will be led by people who have expressed open and public hostility to at least parts of it.
We often talk about the news deluge that we're all experiencing, and this morning is no different, because that big Rosenstein news this morning comes at the very same time that we can report a major development in the Mueller probe. Lawyers for former Trump campaign chief Paul Manafort inadvertently revealed that Paul Manafort shared internal Trump polling data with one of his Russian associates who is tied to Russian intelligence. It is the clearest evidence yet of collusion between the Trump campaign and Russia. Meanwhile, there's also a government shutdown, and the president meets again with congressional leaders today after his Oval Office address last night to the nation, where he made his case for the border wall. This as the government shutdown enters day 19. But first, let's get to Laura Jarrett. She is live in Washington with all of the breaking Rosenstein news. What have you learned, Laura?
Allison, good morning. Well, Rosenstein, the number two official at the Justice Department, the man who has been overseeing the Russia investigation since its very inception, plans to leave the department soon after Bill Barr, the president's pick for attorney general, is confirmed by the Senate. Now, I'm told by a source familiar with Rosenstein's thinking that he's not being forced out by the White House, but he has informed them of his plans, and he wants to ensure a smooth transition for Barr. Naturally, he never planned on staying forever, and it's understood that if confirmed, Barr would want his own deputy at the department. But of course, the big question this raises is what effect, if any, Rosenstein's departure would have on the Mueller investigation, the Russia investigation, as Rosenstein has been running the probe since he appointed Mueller in May of 2017 and has continued to oversee it day to day, even after Matthew Whitaker came on as the acting attorney general in November. But this news, of course, only raises the stakes for Bill Barr's confirmation next week as well, which was already going to be contentious given his past critical statements on Mueller. John?
He will be asked, will you let the investigation go on? How much latitude will they have? Does Mueller have the right to investigate obstruction? All of these things out in the open in the next few days. Laura, stick around with us. Also joining us now, the author of The Threat Matrix, Inside Robert Mueller's FBI and the War on Global Terror, Garrett Graff, and CNN political analyst David Gregory. Garrett, Rod Rosenstein, the Deputy Attorney General, has become a household name, which you cannot often say about Deputy Attorney Generals, right, or Attorneys General, I should say. He's become this big deal. He's let this investigation go on. He appointed Robert Mueller. With him gone, what impact does that have?
It's hard to say, and I think that sort of one of the things is that, you know, in this news-packed environment, it's important to understand that this really is potentially a totally normal thing. Deputies, attorneys general typically serve about 18 months, so the idea that Rod Rosenstein will have actually made it 2 years is, in fact, one of the most fascinating aspects of Rod Rosenstein's tenure at the Justice Department. I mean, as you said, this is someone who we have woken up every morning for 18 months wondering if he's been fired overnight. I can't even count the number of breaking news events where we thought he was being fired, you know, within the hour. And this is someone who has overseen the probe, as you said, and has protected Robert Mueller since his appointment. And I think in many ways, one of the things that we can say is that if Rod Rosenstein is stepping down, he understands that his legacy and his the way that history views him is tied up in the Mueller probe and sort of whether he did a good job protecting that. And so if Rod Rosenstein is planning to step down, in some ways that's the strongest sign that things are okay with the Mueller probe and that Rod Rosenstein feels confident that the investigation will continue through to its conclusion.
One more thing about Rod Rosenstein, David Gregory. You know, my FBI sources, they hold him in such high regard. They really felt that the Mueller probe was in good hands with him, and they felt that Rod Rosenstein's just personal credentials that were really sterling, and that he put country above personal ambition or anything else. And, you know, he received a lot of the president's wrath. over these past 18 months or however it's long. You know, the president retweeted that image of Rod Rosenstein as being one of the people behind bars. So it's not a surprise that he would want to exit at this point. And who knows what this means for the Mueller probe.
Right, but it is, as Garrett says, a little bit more orderly because there were so many points along this path where he could have been fired, where we thought he was going to be fired over disclosures to the New York Times about his thinking about Trump and whether he should be opposed by those within the cabinet, invoking the 25th Amendment, where he said he was just joking. It's clearer here that conversations between Rosenstein and the White House could have been, look, he's going to want a new attorney general. When that happens, you should probably go with him. Maybe Rosenstein said that. But I am hard-pressed to believe that that there's any problem with the probe. I think that Rosenstein, who's been working with Mueller, overseeing Mueller, mm-hmm. I think Mueller's an adult. I think he understands what the timetable looks like and what the politics are like here in terms of just going forward with his job. I think everybody understands that. And I think, as you said, John, the questions now for Barr will just be, will you let him finish his job? And I think that will be the commitment that they try to wrest out of him.
And it'll be interesting to see if senators, particularly Republican senators, demand an answer to that. We're so used to hearings where people, nominees, squirm out of answers to specific questions. This is a pretty basic question that William Barr should answer. And we can point out where he's been on some of these matters. You pointed out that when Robert Mueller was appointed, at first he was good with that.
Before Bill Barr didn't like the Mueller probe, he did like the Mueller probe. So in May of 2017, William Barr said this about Robert Mueller's appointment. His appointment is good news for those concerned over the troubling way the investigation was handled over the summer and fall, as well as the many government leaks, Barr told this news organization. He added, I am confident that Mueller will keep his eye on legitimate areas of inquiry and not let this investigation degenerate into a sprawling, ceaseless witch hunt to get something on the president's associates.
However, a year later, and this is, by the way, he always thought that it was legal to fire James Comey, which is something that Mueller is at least looking around into. A year later, in June of 2018, Bill Barr said Mueller should not be able to demand the president submit to an interrogation about alleged obstruction if embraced by the department. This theory would have potentially disastrous implications, not just for the presidency, but for the executive branch as a whole and the department in particular. You know, Laura, I think a lot of people thought Bill Barr was a safe nominee because he's held the job before and seen as an establishment figure. On the other hand, he's also someone who has had problems with the way Robert Mueller has done some things.
Yeah, I think he was widely, even by Democrats, praised initially until that memo came out where he had gone on for something like almost 20 pages explaining why he thought Mueller should not be delving into obstruction of justice surrounding the firing of FBI Director James Comey. And, you know, his view is espoused by many conservatives who think that this is sort of a unitary executive, and so the president can't be under investigation for something he was allowed to do. The firing is something he can do as president. But it's interesting, when Rosenstein was asked about those comments at a press conference just a few short weeks ago, he said Barr doesn't have all the facts. And so it's clear there that he at least wanted to distance himself, at least in some way, from those comments. And he said, you know, obviously people make comments about the probe all the time, but the people here at the Justice Department really know what's going on. But I think the big question for Barr is, what does he do with the report? So even if Rosenstein is gone by the time Mueller has sort of formally wrapped the investigation part of it, meaning the grand jury is winding down, all the sentencing is, what happens to that report? And if that takes many more months after Rosenstein is gone, how does Barr handle that? I think that's the big question.
Because where does the report go, right? I mean, ultimately, this becomes a political process if there's ever going to be impeachment. That's an issue for the House and for the Senate. And the person who is overseeing the investigation can make a decision about what gets into a report, what is ultimately sent up to Congress, what becomes public. And that's why his opinions about whether obstruction of justice is a fair game in this investigation, whether this has become a witch hunt, the hopeful sign is just that, is that Rosenstein has said, well, he doesn't know everything, and then he falls into line once he knows the full breadth of the investigation.